The market is pricing in that 25 basis point cut in April of 2020. On Friday, the market was pricing in that cut in the second half of 2020. So that's been pulled over. Maybe the market's looking at today and feeling a little comfort and maybe get the cut a lot sooner. But I think to your point, Scott, just back to this rhetoric for one second that the president is engaging in right now with the Chinese, I think we're in a dangerous place in the sense of this. Do we, as market participants, have to expect that this remains with us throughout the duration into the 2020 presidential election? Because there's a belief that including this as part of that presidential platform benefits the president. It forces the Democrats to have an answer, a response. What's your position on how to deal with the economic threat from the Chinese? Democrats have to answer for that. So as market participants, we might be dealing with this throughout 19 into the election.
And that's the point. I think either you buy into this and you stay invested in the market and you say, look, I'm not a fan of Trump's, but he's done a lot to get us where we are in the economy, rolling back regulations, tax cut. And I do believe the Chinese are out of control in terms of how they come after our free economy and our trade. But you have to be able to, you have to buy into it and live with the rhetoric, or you have to get out. You just can't pick the parts of it that you want. So I'm still in. When that news, when that tweet broke, I said to my daughter, "So, oh, what's going to happen, Mark Barr? So it's going to get crushed." This is not a crushing. This is a normal sell-off. Now, it's not a one-day event. I agree. It depends on the rhetoric.
Let me do this. Ron Insana, how do you view things? You know, where we ended on Friday, we seem to be in a good place. And here we find ourselves on Monday back with this feeling of uncertainty, not sure if the trade deal is going to happen by the end of the week or not.
Yeah, well, I think, you know, I think some analysts, and not ours, are giving too much credit to the White House with the notion that it's playing three-dimensional chess, that it's worked in a rate cut or asked for a rate cut because they know there's trouble coming on the trade front, even though the economy's in Goldilocks mode. I think, look, you can go back to April 25th, and there was a published report suggesting that both Steve Bannon and Kyle Bass were urging the president to walk away from the trade talks, others urging him to get even tougher, which we're now seeing with respect to the threat of tariffs. Now, Gene Sperling, a former Clinton and Obama economic official, was on this morning, was saying that when you're dealing with Asian countries, doing this publicly and so overtly is counterproductive. And there were two published reports out this morning that highlighted that. One, if you box in China's President Xi, he might have to back away so he doesn't look weak. And then there was a Washington Post report this morning out this suggesting that individual investors in China are looking at this and saying, listen, with the push of a button, the president of the United States is killing us in the stock market. And they believe, according to this report, that the president is out to annihilate the Chinese economy. You start developing that kind of sentiment in China, and, you know, do they walk away from the table altogether and say, listen, you're not negotiating in good faith. This isn't how it's supposed to go. We were close. It's your fault that things are falling apart. And then we end up in a stalemate. That is something that the markets have not anticipated, as both Steve and Joe suggested. And I'm worried that they're being a little too cute by half here.